The Electric has just reported that Tesla has confirmed its acquisition of a battery startup company in a new patent. Hello, my friends, and welcome to the Electric Viking. Fantastic to see you here today. It is 2:45 a.m. on a Saturday morning here in Melbourne, Australia. My name is Sam Evans. Thank you for subscribing to the channel, liking the channel, and supporting the movement towards having a better planet. Ultimately, that's what it's about. But realistically, it's also about logic. Why drive a petrol or diesel car when you can get an electric car? Let's support the movement and make sure it happens faster. That said, it's all happening faster than even I, the most optimistic of the optimists for electric cars, predicted. I made a video about that. I'll put that video in a link in the description below. Now, if you haven't already started investing in this movement, it's about time you did, don't you think? I mean, seriously, billions of dollars have been made already, and many more billions will be made as the entire industry shifts from fossil fuels to renewable energy, to clean energy, to clean cars. You might as well take advantage of this fact that you are smarter than the average person. You're watching this channel. You're going to know more than the average person about how you can take advantage of this opportunity. Check out lots of my videos. I talk about companies you can invest in order to do that. Now, if you want to do that, jump on Stake, create an account using the link in the description below. That'll give you a free stock. Might as well get started. Tesla confirmed that it quietly acquired Colorado-based battery startup Solion Inc. in a new patent for a silicon-based battery anode. I'm sure one of you realizes that I didn't pronounce that correctly. So put in the comments below how to correctly pronounce this startup. I'm intrigued to know how you pronounce it. Over the past few years, Tesla has been rumored to have acquired Solion Inc., a battery technology startup based out of Colorado. Now, these rumors, Electric says, started after a few of the startup's employees were hired by Tesla and the automaker started listing battery research jobs in Colorado, where it previously did not have any R&D operations. Now, this startup was working on a new high energy density battery chemistry based on high loaded silicon anodes. You'd think there's a good chance that Tesla will use that if they bought the company. Well, there's another reason they bought them as well, but I think there's a good chance that Tesla will be looking at using this new battery chemistry potentially in a future Tesla Model S Plaid, a Plaid Plus, something like that, maybe even the Roadster. Now, on its website, this is what it said before the website was shut down. Developer of an advanced lithium-ion battery designed to address the market's accelerated demand for high-performance energy storage devices. Well, Tesla Roadster would be perfect for that. The company's technology delivers high-energy batteries by simultaneously incorporating high-loaded silicon anodes, nickel-rich NMC cathodes, and a non-flammable ionic liquid electrolyte, and offer an increase in both energy density and specific energy in lithium-ion batteries, enabling users to get safer and lower-cost energy storage devices for defense, consumer electronics, and electric vehicle applications. Now, I'm sorry if I didn't deliver that very well because it was one of the longest paragraphs I've read in a long time without a full stop. So the startup received several grants from the U.S. Department of Defense and the U.S. Department of Energy before they went dark in 2018. Website disappeared. No one knew what the hell happened. They just disappeared. While three researchers at the company changed their job positions on LinkedIn to being at Tesla, co-founders Tyler Evans and Daniela Molina never did. But Electric says they can now confirm that their technology is now owned by Tesla. I'm intrigued what Tesla paid for this. Love to know. Does anyone know? If you do, let us know in the comment below. Now, one of the Solion duo's most important patents, called large format battery anodes comprising silicon particles, is now listed as Tesla's. So Tesla is listed as the applicant for the patent, while Evans and Molina Piper are listed as the inventors. They describe the anode technology in the patent's abstract. Large-scale anodes containing high weight percentages of silicon suitable for use in lithium-ion energy storage devices and batteries, and methods of manufacturing the same are described. The anode material described herein can include a film cast on a current collector substrate with a film including a plurality of active material particles and a conductive polymer membrane coated over the active material particles. I don't understand what that means. If someone can explain it in layman's terms, please do so. In some embodiments, the conductive polymer membrane comprises polyacrylonitrile, or PAN. The method of manufacturing the nanomaterial can include preparation of a slurry, including the active material particles and the conductive polymer material, coating the slurry on a current collector substrate, and subjecting the composite material to drying and heat treatments. Now, very interestingly, during Tesla's battery day, the automaker confirmed that its new 4680 cell is powered by a new anode enabled by a new silicon. Now, recently, Lucid's CEO claimed that Tesla's 4680 cell and pack is not really all that good. It's not all that impressive, and it's not a game changer. I made a video about what he said and about my opinion about what he said. I think he's wrong. I'll put a link in the description below to that video. Now, earlier this week, The Electric reported that Tesla delivered a new anode production line at Gigafactory, Texas. I'll put a link in the description below to that article. It wouldn't be the only battery startup that Tesla required to secure technology for its next-gen 4680 battery cell. Now, Tesla actually also acquired Canada's Spring Power International for its cathode technology. So Tesla have acquired quite a few companies over the last few years for their technology. Now, I believe it was actually Sandy Munro who said that all the great power innovations usually get classified or they go dark, disappear after proving themselves. Now, what I'm most interested to see is if this technology is actually employed in Tesla's new 4680 cells when we finally get to see them next year. I'm excited to see them. Tell me what you think about Tesla buying these startup companies. Do you think it's a good move? Do you think Tesla should keep doing it? Would you buy a Tesla? What electric car are you looking to buy right now? Thank you for watching the video. Thanks for supporting the channel. And I look forward to seeing you once again on the next electric car video. Have a great day. Bye-bye.